arts, novel, art and craft. Art and craft shop with Arts and There.
Hi friends, I'm Jagan from Raj Noho Arts and Crafts. Today I'm going to show you how we prepare this mug paste for Thanjur painting. This mug paste is available in ready-made form also. We will show you in the final end of the video how to use this ready-made paste also. This is the mug powder, which is nothing but the purified form of limestone powder. This mug powder is already sieved, but you can also sieve it if required. So now this mug powder will be directly added with the Arabic gum. This Arabic gum is also in liquid form available ready in our store, or add 1 cup of Arabic gum with 1 cup of water and store it for 24 hours, and you can see the next day the Arabic gum turns into honey. Then you can filter it and store it in a bottle. All these we have put already in the channel in detail. Please check below description for how to prepare Arabic gum video links. Now let us go into the most requested subject, that is how to prepare this mug paste. First and foremost, before you are going to make a mug paste, you have to soak this powder for 2 to 3 days, thereby you have to make them soft. We have taken a 500 gram container and fill half of the container with mug powder and add water step by step, that is not directly. You should not pour full water in it. You have to add it little by little and stir this powder into a semi-solid batter paste. Why I am telling batter is, after 2 to 3 days the paste becomes more puffy and more soft due to some fermentation happening between the powder and the water. Then put it in a airtight for 3 to 4 days. More the duration you keep, more smoothness you will get while preparing the mug paste. After 2 days the paste has come so soft and puffy. So this is the paste you are going to use for mug paste. So take 4 spoons of this batter paste in a filter and then add 2 spoons of Arabic gum, that is full spoon of Arabic gum. The Arabic gum should be in a thick honey consistency, and start stirring in the filter. This is a steel filter. You can use plastic filter or even a cloth. The more the filter you do, the more smoother and effective the paste will become. The correct ratio for preparing Thanjur painting design mug paste is 2:1. 2 spoons of batter paste, 1 spoon of Arabic gum. For us, this ratio has given a very good result, but it differs between different artists. The most important thing is Arabic gum should be in a thick honey form, not in a watery form. This 2:1 ratio is same for design paste. So we have not added any Arabic gum, just stir it. So after stirring for a long time, you will be coming for the thick paste. This is how it flows. There will be no flow of thick paste, that is, this is the design paste or the relief work paste, where you will be designing the cone work and the relief work in your Thanjur painting. When you purchase this ready-made mug paste, this is the same consistency you will get in that bottle, and you can start the cone work or the designing work for your Thanjur painting. Let me show you how to prepare the base filling paste. The base filling paste should be quite watery. Like a cement, it has to grip the stones and also the board. So just add 1 spoon of Arabic gum to that design paste. So the correct ratio of making a base filling paste is 2:2. That is 2 spoon of batter paste with 2 spoon of Arabic gum, so that it becomes more watery, and this watery paste easily fills the gaps, board, stones, etc. Wherever it flows like a falls, same like this. It should flow with a string. There should be no gap. You can see here, after stirring for a long time, you can see the smooth and continuous flow of this base filling paste. we have not added any water. The water is already in the batter paste. So then only you will be getting such a very good consistency. I have learned some tips in many channels, but one channel that impressed me a lot for tandoori painting is one of our best friend channel. It is a small library of tandoori painting. Whatever the tips you want, you can learn that. It has more than 100 videos all related to tandoori painting. That is my main thing. And also very good explanation for each and every tip is explained in that channel. I have put the channel link in description below. And also learn many more tips related to tandoori painting. If you know Tamil, you will surely be very much impressed with that channel for preparing the mug paste. We also followed some tips from that channel. Thanks a lot to my friend for making such a very good informative video, and hoping her lot success. After preparing both the paste, you can fill up in a cone. I have put separately a cone video in our channel. Check description for cone video also, how to prepare a cone. There I have elaborated how to prepare a thick cone and design cone. Immediately after you prepare the mug paste, you have to check whether the paste that I have produced will produce any cracks or not. Don't use the paste directly on the main board for designing or base filling. To check the paste consistency, take a rough board and make a drop in the rough board and allow it to dry for 2 to 3 hours. While pouring, the paste should be shining like this, and there should be no water bubbles or any other lumps should be formed. It should flow like this, and after 3 hours you can see the paste will be like this, shining and embossing as the way it has been poured. This is the base filling watery cone that we have produced. 2:2 is the ratio, and you can see how it is spreading. And this is the 2:1 ratio, design cone ratio. You can easily draw circles, comma, lines, straight lines, and also oval, all other designs in this design cone. If the Arabic gum consistency is watery, you can add a few drops of Fevicol mixed water, and this is, you can see how the design cone is giving very good results. Apply Fevicol at the base of the board before adding the design cone or the watery cone, then only your cone life will last long. This tip is for the beginners, and this is the OHP transparent sheet. And for hand coordination, just keep a sketch below the transparent sheet and start your cone work. The lines, the commas, all others, just follow the sketch. Then you will be getting a good legible sketch. And please add Fevicol, as I told earlier, before doing the cone work. And this is for my customers, when they purchase this mug paste, it will be already in a design paste form. That is, you can start designing with this paste itself. There is no need to add any Arabic gum or any other thing. Sometimes in transit or in sunny days, if it is dry, just add a small quantity of Arabic gum, and the main part is you have to stir it very well. Then only you will be getting a design paste in a working condition. And many people have asked whether should I keep it in a refrigerator. No, there is no need to do any refrigeration. So now if you want to make a base filling paste, just add 1/2 spoon. That is 2:2 ratio will be coming if you have added 1/2 spoon. And when you stir this paste continuously, you will be getting this base filling paste. Another question I get from my customer is, how many days can you store this mug paste? You can store this mug paste minimum 1 to 2 months, that too in a room temperature, no need to refrigerate.
So you can see the string is falling like falls. So you can also check this before using on the main board. So this glossy consistency ensures that the mug paste is coming without any cracks. Another query is, can I use Fevicol instead of Arabic gum? Yeah, you can use Fevicol, but you will be getting just 60 to 70% results when compared to Arabic gum. Arabic gum is highly recommended for mug paste as it is very smooth than the Fevicol. After you use the paste, please store the remaining paste in a airtight container only. Another query is, can mug powder use directly without soaking in water? Yeah, you can use mug powder directly while liquidating the mug powder into a paste. You will be adding Arabic gum and water you need. While adding water, you have to add this Fevicol mixed water, not direct water. Always think about it. Adding only water will surely bring cracks in your paste. Please add Fevicol mixed water or Arabic gum mixed water, and then you dilute the paste into the base filling paste like that. But this technique gives just 60 to 80% results. These tips are for those people where Arabic gum is not easily available or don't have any time for making soaked paste. So for Tanjore painting materials, you can just WhatsApp us and get all the materials in detail. You can see here, just we have added 2 to 3 drops of Fevicol in half the tumbler of water, and just we will be adding, you can add this water in the paste. Another advantage for adding Arabic gum in mug paste is, while cleaning the stones, it doesn't reduce the clarity of the stones. It does not stick stubbornly like Fevicol, or it does not leave any powdery stains on the kundans like Fevicol does on the kundan. And Arabic gum being a natural gum,
if the paste has dried to toothpaste thickness,
you can regain it by adding Fevicol mixed water or Arabic gum mixed water. Please store the mug paste filled cone in airtight container for best results. And here is how the watery base filling paste is flowing like a falls, you can see. And after it dries, it does not create any cracks also. And another query is, can I use French chalk powder or Bombay chalk powder instead of mug powder? Yeah, you can use it, but we have got very good results in this mug powder due to high elevation and good embossing, and the design cone is also very strong. But in French chalk powder, we have not got this much of embossing effect, but they are also good. With some artists, that they are playing very good wonders with the French chalk powder also. Hats off to them. Most of the senior artists also use Bombay chalk powder for best results, and this is the most traditional use of mug paste, that is using the brush instead of cone work. And this is the same base filling paste that they are filling, and this is how you use the design paste or the cone paste. Tanjore painting classes are taken in Madurai in our art center, and for any Tanjore painting materials that you need, feel free to WhatsApp us or order in our 2 websites. Waiting for your valuable comments. Thank you for watching. Kindly do subscribe our channel.